God's commandments as Christ taught us by loving God and our neighbor. Do you clearly understand what you're undertaking? Okay. Are you ready to help? Are you ready to help the parents of this child in their duty as Christian parents? The Pope of the Christian community welcomes you with great joy. In his name, we claim you for Christ our Savior by the sign of his cross. I now trace the cross on your forehead and invite your parents and godparents to the same. So you just sign the cross. So therefore, your fathers forgive you. Will you not give us life, and show not your people rejoice in you? Show us, O Lord, your kindness, and grant us your salvation. I will hear what God proclaims, Lord, for he proclaims peace to his people. We'll read the scripture reading. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. That's chapter 28, verses 18 through 20. Jesus said to the 11 disciples, "All power on earth and heaven and earth have been given to me. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and the Holy Spirit. Teach them to observe all that I have commanded you. And behold, I'm with you always until the end of time." The gospel of God. Praise to Jesus Christ. Jesus commanded his apostles to baptize them in the church. Receive the Holy Spirit through the baptism or the Trinity. But that's just not enough. You know, just like we have to keep dealing with. Right now, they're totally helpless. They should teach them things. Now, they will pick up stuff on their own as they get older. But right now, they're totally helpless. As a parent and a sponsor, you have to help raise this child so they understand the faith. They just don't come up with a little understanding. And they'll also watch not only what you say, but your behavior. I've got grandkids. It's amazing what we have from parents. Most of them mess up. But anyway, they pick that stuff up. So a big part of your raising is to set good example. Generosity, kindness to others, trying to control their anger. We all get angry at times. And if we bring them to church, as they get younger, as they get older, we have liturgy for the children. Because sometimes we talk a little bit over with dads. But they'll watch you. If you go to church, they'll be inclined to go to church. If you don't go to church, they just think it's not necessary. So you have a big responsibility. Because now, as a grandfather, I'm going to tell you that you never get done raising your kids. You think you got them out of the nest, that's always something you're still raising, until I get completely, I'm no longer around. But I always have to show my kids something. So it's a big responsibility to take it on. Saints, it's a short portion, and your response is pray for them. Holy Mary of God, pray for us. St. John the Baptist, pray for us. St. Joseph, pray for us. St. Peter and St. Paul, pray for us. All holy men and women, pray for us. Almighty and ever-living God, we send your only Son into the world to cast out the power of Satan, spirit of evil, to rescue man from the kingdom of darkness, to bring him into the splendor of your kingdom of life. We pray for this child, save him free from original sin, make him a temple of your glory, and send your Holy Spirit to dwell within him. We ask this in Christ our Lord. Amen. You with the oil of salvation in the name of Christ our Savior. May he strengthen you with his power, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. May you have the strength and the power of Christ our Savior, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.